In this video of general physiology, we are gonna revise the concept of mole, osmol, difference between osmolarity and osmolality, osmotic adaptation and osmotic pressures. So let us start to discuss between mole. What is a mole? Mole is a gram molecular weight of a substance. So any substance whose molecular weight is expressed in a gram, that is termed as 1 mole. Let us take an example of an oxygen atom. So 32 gram of oxygen has 1 mole of oxygen. That means that 1 mole of oxygen contains the oxygen with a 32 gram of molecular weight. Clear? Another example, that is albumin. The molecular weight of albumin is 69,000. So 69,000 gram of albumin makes 1 mole. What is the concept of millimole? Millimole is nothing but it is 1 by 1000 of a mole. Millimole is 1 by 1000 of a mole. So the concept of mole and millimole is clear. Next topic is osmol. What is an osmol? Osmol or effective osmol, that is osmotic active particles that are capable of causing osmosis. So any particle that can cause osmosis that contain a osmol. The general examples, that is sodium, chloride, protein and phosphate ion. What is the more common examples of an osmol? That is sodium, chlorine, protein and a phosphate. What is the formula calculating in an osmol? So one osmol is equal to 1 by number of freely moving particles liberated in a solution. One osmol is equal to 1 by number of freely moving particles liberated in a solutions. Example, that is sodium chloride. If a sodium chloride is dissolved in water, it is split into two parts. First part is of sodium and second part is of chloride. So one osmol of sodium chloride contains 1 mole of sodium chloride by 2 because it is split into two particles. So 1 mole of sodium chloride is equal to 2 osmol. Similarly, if you take another example of CaCl2. So 1 mole of CaCl2 contains 3 osmol. That is, it contains 1 molecule of calcium and 2 molecules of chloride. Another example is 1 mole of C6H12O6. So 1 mole of C6H12O6 contain 1 osmol because C6H12O6 nothing but it is a glucose. So 1 mole of C6H12O6 contain 1 osmol. Moving on to the next topic, that is the difference between osmolarity and osmolality. What is that? Osmolarity is nothing but it is number of osmols of solute per liter of solution. Osmolarity, that is solute per liter of solutions. What is osmolality? Osmolality is number of osmol of solute per kg of a solvent. So per kg of solvent, that is osmolality, and the solute per liter of solution, that is osmolarity. If you ask me which one of the best, that is osmolarity or osmolality, I will tell the osmolarity is best because this osmolarity is not affected by any of the condition such as temperature or the presence of other solute. So which one is best? Osmolarity. Now solve some of the MCQs. That is, if you have the normal plasma osmolarity, what is the normal plasma osmolarity? The options are 260 to 270, 270 to 280, 280 to 290, or 290 to 300. The correct answer for this, that is 280 to 290. So the range of normal plasma osmolarity, that is 280 to 290. If they have asked specifically like which one of the following is plasma osmolarity, and they have given the value of 270 80 90 300, so the correct answers will be 290. Let us think why this plasma will having high osmolarity and which contribute the maximum osmolarity. So next question goes like this: what contribute the maximum osmolarity? Your options are sodium is associated, potassium, glucose, urea and plasma protein. Options are sodium, potassium, glucose, urea and plasma protein. The correct answer is sodium and is associated. Most of the people will think that this plasma protein is having high contribution to plasma osmolarity, but that is wrong. The correct answer is sodium and is associated. What do you mean by sodium and is associated? That means sodium can't always alone. It will be always with any chlorine, but will be always with any bicarbonate. This consists of 140 osmol. So 240 osmol. So sodium alone will make 240 osmol. What about the potassium? Since potassium lies in intracellular compartment, so it contributes very few. What about glucose and urea? This glucose contribute 5 osmols and urea contribute also 5 osmols. What about the plasma protein? If you see the total contribution of this plasma protein, this will be approx 2%. So out of this, which one of the following contribute the maximum osmolarity, that is sodium and is associated, sodium is associated. Now we'll discuss why this plasma protein contain very less, why it contribute very less amount of osmolarity. If you see the normal value of any plasma protein, that is 6 to 8 g/mL, or you can write it at 6 to 8 g/dL. If you take this albumin alone, that is 3.5 to 5 g/100 mL or dL. So in our body, albumin contains 3.5 to 5 g. If you convert this into liter, so 1 liter is equal to 35 to 50 g. This is in liter. But what we have asked, the question asked in osmolarity. So we have to convert this into mole. As we have studied previously that 69,000 grams of albumin makes 1 osmol. What is the total content of osmols in our body? That is 35 to 50. So 50 gram of albumin makes 0.007 moles of albumin. So it consists 0.007 moles. So 50 grams of albumin, that is equal to 1 into 50 by 69,000, that is 0.007. So this is very less. Similar, that means that if the molecular weight is high, so if the molecular weight is high of any protein or any substance, the osmol or osmolarity will be less or it is decreased. Got my point? Because albumin is having high molecular weight, its osmolarity is very less. Another question they ask, that is plasma protein contributes only 2% to osmolarity because your options are high molecular concentrations, high molecular weight, high molar concentrations and less molecular weight, low molar concentrations, high molecular weight and low molar concentrations and low molecular weight. This answer you will get in the previous question, that is why this plasma protein contribute only 2% osmolarity, because this plasma protein contain low molar concentrations but high molecular weight. If you see the molecular weight of albumin, that is 69,000. For other proteins will have 140,000, or it may goes up to like 400,000. So plasma protein contributes only 2% of osmolarity. If they've asked that plasma protein contribute only 2 osmols, the osmolarity because why? Your options are high concentration or high molecular weight, low concentration, high molecular weight, high concentration, low molecular weight, and the low concentration, low molecular weight. In this, they have given the osmolarity. That means they have given in deciliter. Okay, they have given in deciliters. What do you know? All these plasma proteins contain high molecular weight. So this answer will have any one of the high molecular weight. Got it. Now second thing is like they have asked in 2 milliosmoles, that I already told, that is in deciliters. That means if you see this concentrations, it will be high, but if you see in molar concentration, it will be very low. Note this point. If you will see the thing in concentration of a plasma protein, that is very high. What is that? That is 35 to 50 grams, that is more. But if you see in molar concentration, that is 0.007, that is very less. So plasma protein contributes only 2 osmols to osmolarity because it is having high concentrations and high molecular weight. Got this? Next topic we're gonna discuss, that is osmotic adaptation. What is osmotic adaptation? Osmotic adaptation, it is the process by which a cells adapt with the change in osmotic pressures or change in osmotic concentrations. If you see, if you're having increase in sodium concentration in serum, so the plasma osmolarity increases. If you'll have a decrease in sodium serum concentrations, so you'll have decrease in plasma osmolarity. If you're having increase in either intracellular or extracellular, you'll have change in plasma osmotic concentrations till it reaches to equilibrium. If you take an example of chronic hypernatremia, that taste will have increase in sodium for more than 24 hours. That's why it is chronic. What happens means your brain cells shows adaptations. So if you're having chronic hypernatremia, your brain cells shows adaptations. So what type of adaptation does the brain cell shows? Two types of adaptation, that is, first, increase in intracellular synthesis of osmol, right? And second one is import of sodium. That is, what is the intracellular synthesis of osmol? That is, it will secrete betaine, it will secrete inositol, and it will secrete glutamide. So this intracellular secretions of osmolite, it will balance it and it will cause the equilibrium. If you're having hyponatremia, the things will be opposite. You'll have intracellular synthesis of osmolite, it will decrease in hyponatremia. Instead of having this import of sodium, you'll have export of potassium. So the condition will be opposite in chronic hyponatremia. Next is like osmotic pressure. What is osmotic pressure? Osmotic pressure is a pressure which is required to stop the flux of water across a membrane. If you're having two different concentration in a tube, in this you're having low concentration and if you're having high concentration, as you know that the substance will move from lower concentration to through osmosis, the substance will move from lower concentration to higher concentration. So what is osmotic pressure? Osmotic pressure is pressure which is required to stop the movement of the osmosis through the semipermeable membrane. From this equation we know that P equal to CRT, where P is the osmotic pressure, C is the concentration in osmoles, and R is a constant and T is a temperature. This equation is known as Van 't Hoff equation. So what is Van 't Hoff equation? That is P equal to CR3. In a steady state, the osmolarity of all body fluid is identical. That is, osmotic pressure gradient across the plasma membrane of a cell state is zero. If it is steady state, so the plasma membrane steady state will be zero. What is 1 osmole of a solute? So 1 milliosmole of a solute, that is equal to 19.3 mm of Hg. This is one of the important questions, just note this point. 1 milliosmole of a solute, that is equal to 19.3 mm of Hg. What will be 1 osmole of a solute exit pressure? That is 19,300 mm of Hg, or 22.4 atmosphere. 1 milliosmole of a solute, that is 19.3 mFSG. 1 osmole of a solute that exerts a pressure of 19,300 mFSG, or 22.4 atmospheric pressures. What is normal osmotic pressure of a plasma? The normal osmotic pressure of a plasma, that is 219 to 19.3. Why this is 290? 290 is the normal osmolarity of a plasma, that is 55,597 mFSG. What is colloidal osmotic pressure? It is the oncotic pressures responsible for tissue fluid formations. So the pressure excreted by a protein, that is 25 to 20 mFSG. So what is the pressure excreted by the protein? So this is the protein. These proteins are formed due to colloidal osmotic pressure, that is 25 to 20 mFSG. You got a question here, that is protein which contribute maximum to the osmotic pressures. Your options are albumin, globulin, prothrombin, and fibrogen. So you need to select the options which contribute maximum. Again, recall this previous what we have discussed, that is the substance which is having high concentrations and a low molecular weight will contribute maximum to the osmotic pressures, that is albumin. Got the answers? Albumin having high concentrations but low molecular weight. You can ask me that I have told that albumin having a molecular weight of 16,000, but why you have selecting this low molecular weight as compared to other protein such as globulin, prothrombin, and fibrogen? Albumin having very less, globulin having 16,000. Globulin will have 140,000 molecular weight. Prothrombin will have more than that is 400,000 gram molecular. So as compared to everyone, this albumin will have less molecular weight. So this is the thing which you should know about moles, osmolarity, osmolality, osmotic adaptations and osmotic pressure.